So my question to you is, what type of man will you be? Very serious question. So what type of man will you be? So how many people know that they have a choice to decide? Right. You have a choice to decide what type of man you'll be. So I really enjoyed one of William's points, because his point was exactly the same point that I'm about to make here. So when we talk about men, we talk about people. There's really three types of people. This is John's simplified, Mr. Martin's simplified version. So there is one type of person who throughout their life basically struggles. How many people know this type of person? Right? So struggle. And when I say struggle, it could be anything from financial, it could be mental, it could be anything. Usually it's somebody who's always got a hustle going, they're always trying to make something happen, but they're really living between check to check. Has anybody ever heard the expression living check to check? Yeah. And that what that means is, you get paid one day, you pay all your bills, and the next thing you know, you don't have any money left. You guys are in a position to determine if you're going to live like that in your life. You literally, the decisions that you make determine how, if you're going to live like that or not. So for me, the next level is success. So how would you define success? They talked a little bit about that. Success is being able to take care of your family. It's being able to live in a nice house. It's being able to work. It's being able to be a productive person in the community. It's being able to, if you have a family, it's being able to send your kids to school, buy a car, buy a house. That's success. That's generally revolves around being able to take care of yourself as a man, right? So that's a certain level of success. But William mentioned, which I thought was really great, that next level, which is called significance. So significance is something more than success. Significance talks about investing in the community. It's being able to give back. These two gentlemen that they both, did you guys notice? They both had foundations. Those foundations are both all about giving back to the community. These guys here are worth a lot of money. But they took their morning to come and speak to you guys. So that talks about significance. So how you invest your time, your wealth, your mind, that talks about significance. So when I ask you what type of man do you want to be, I want you to think about it in terms of these three areas. Now each one of you should have three cards in front of you. Some of y'all might have wrote on them, which is fine. You might have folded them up, balled them up. That's okay, we got some more around them. So, does everyone have a pen? Stand up if you do not have a pen. All right. Never, ever, ever, never, ever, never go somewhere without a writing. Now, I know you guys have phones and other things, but you guys are the only ones in the room that don't have pens. So we have some pens around here. I'll make sure I get one. Dr. Lopez, is there a bag back there? This looks like a money bag. Hold on, I think it's on your table, actually. I think it's on your table. It should have some pens in there, I think. Yes. So if you guys would go see Dr. Lopez, if you don't have a pen, go see Dr. Lopez. He will get you one. We're not going to make him walk. You guys walk over there. I'm trying to sleep over. We got you. We'll excuse you one time for not having a pen and a piece of paper. We like the folks that are well prepared. All right, so here's the exercise for today. Here's this exercise, and it involves your note card. If you've written on the note card, we'll get you another one. Let us know, we'll get you one. So here's your exercise for this moment. So listen to all the instructions before you guys start moving. So So the first thing, you guys are going to all stand up. Listen to the instructions before you start moving. This is number one. So first thing, instruction number one, everybody's going to stand up. Instruction number two.
There you go, stand up.
Instruction number two, you guys are going to introduce yourself to someone you do not know. Instruction number three, you're going to introduce yourself as yourself 10 years from now. So Arthur talked about having three types of goals. What were they? Short-term, mid-term, long-term. So we're gonna give you guys a break. 10 years is going to be your long-term goal. So when I ask you to introduce yourself as if it's 10 years from now. So when you're doing that, you're not going to say, "Hi, my name is John, and I want to be so-and-so." You're going to actually act like it's 10 years from now. So if your goal 10 years from now is to be Arthur Wiley's partner, you say, "Hey, my name is John Martin. I'm the partner of Arthur Wiley. We run this conglomerate business, blah, blah, blah." So I need you to use your imagination to put you 10 years from now. Everybody got it? Everybody got it? You guys are really sharp. I know you got it. So give me the instructions back again. Number one. Number two. Number three. Like it's 10 years from now. All right. Find someone you don't know. I'm going to give you guys. So once you introduce yourself, you guys, once you find someone you don't know, obviously you both can't talk at the same time, so let the other person introduce themselves. All right, so on the count of three, we're going to get that done. One. All right, we got a hand raised. Yes, sir. Put the cards on the table. Put the cards down. No distractions. Sorry about that. Put the cards down. All right. Any other questions? All right. One. Two. Did I get instructions? One. Two. Three. So what's required? Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead. I got you.
My name is Kareem Strickland, and it's basically helping you develop on your shoulder skills at a level to the point you can, you will need to talk to somebody to express your feelings and everything that you honestly need to get out of your experience.
So what's required to do that exercise? What are you using? You're using the communication skills, but someone said imagination. That exercise requires imagination, and then someone said vision, right? So imagination and vision. So those are two very critical things in success. So when Arthur talked about his six steps, what was step number one?
Vision.
So him and I, we hadn't talked about this at all, but vision is so incredibly important, especially for us. When I say us, I mean males in general, minority males for sure. Why is it important for minority males to have our own singular vision? Why? Yes?
Because stereotypes have already envisioned our future for us.
Stereotypes have already envisioned the future for you. How many people understand that stereotypes are real? Right? You guys understand that, right? So, give me a stereotype for black men. Listen to rap, what else? Going to jail, what else?
Lazy,
what else?
Got a baby mama.
Don't take care of the family, what else? Aggressive? Pump to hyper-aggressive? Yes. Sell drugs?
We're always late.
Always late? Only good for athletics. All right, we got it. So no shortage of stereotypes. So give me some stereotypes for Asian Americans.
Smart.
Okay, no math. On athletic. Look alike. Doctors. Yep. All China. Put in manufacturing. All right, we're gonna hold it up there. All right, so he asked a good question when we were talking about stereotypes for black males. Did you notice all the stereotypes for black males were what?
Negative.
Bad. The very first stereotype for Asian American was what? Positive, and what was it?
Smart.
Now, are all Asians smart?
No.
Are all African American males dumb?
No.
Are they all gangsters?
No.
So, why do you need to have a vision for yourself? Because if you don't provide a vision for yourself, someone else will. It's already out there. People already have an expectation of what you're going to be. So that 10-year exercise that you guys just did, if you don't hold on to that as your vision for your success, it won't happen. No one else is going to create that vision for you. That's why it's critically important to have a vision for yourself. Self-image. Our self-image is wrapped around a lot of bad stuff. What I'm asking you to do is step back out of that and think about what kind of man I want to be. Right? What kind of man do I want to be? That's a very simple question. What kind of man do I want to be? So, now the rest of the exercise. So you guys now have the note cards. So, on the note card, I want you to write your 10-year goal. So you already stood up and told somebody what that is. And I want you to write it the same way you just talked about it. Your 10-year goal. So I'm going to give you guys 5 minutes to write that down. Shouldn't take you that long, but 5 minutes to write that down. When you get done writing your goal down, please stand up. That's how I know you're done. Okay, guys, I think I got everybody standing. Anybody not standing? I want to give everybody at the top. Anybody not standing? All right, keep standing. So, first of all, I want you guys to understand this might be the most important thing that you guys ever do. Writing down your vision. Writing down your vision is critically important. If you get this part right, then you can achieve what you have on the paper. Regardless of how wildly bold and impossible it sounds, if you get this right, you can get it done. So the next set of exercises we're going to do after Mr. Collins speaks, we'll continue to build on this. So, thing I want you to remember, if you don't get anything else out of what we're doing today, you have to take this goal, this vision that you have. I need you to look at it every day. Put it by in your wallet, put it by on your mirror. If you look at this every day, it'll start to attract and come into your life. If you really want this goal to happen, that's what you have to do. That's part of the work that you got to do. It's part of the job that you got to do. So, that's critically important. I want you guys to make sure you remember that. Thank you guys for giving me the time to help you make this next step. You guys to take a seat. All right, so are you ready to talk? You are? Okay, Mr. Collins told me to talk a little bit first, so I will do that. All right, so can I have one volunteer to tell me their vision? Hold on.
I'm Jared Collier, and my 10-year goal is to graduate from college and fulfill my lifelong dream of becoming an aeronautical engineer. And I will also be giving back to the community because I also enjoy doing community service. And I'll be working on a new invention to help out and just make a new invention.
One of my favorite books by one of my favorite authors. So this is Blueprint Mentoring Designs for Young Males by Victor Collins Painting. It's a nice and may sign for you. Again, as a leader, we appreciate you stepping up and telling us your vision. We know that it'll come true. So I get to you. All right. Anyone else? Someone else? First hands up, the first one gets the job done. Yes, sir.
My name is Big Quanchet, and in 10 years I will become Academy Award winning actor.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. All right, I'm gonna have you, come back up as well. I'm gonna have you guys work in the structure of what I mean here. So I need you to envision yourself 10 years from now. Mr. John Mark has just asked you to come and speak before this group, and you need to introduce yourself.
25. All right. How are you doing? My name is Big Mark Cherry, and I just finished this move in Tyler Perry, and it was great. But, yeah, y'all see it in the years coming soon. I don't tell you too much about it until I get sued. But, as much as I know, y'all can make it, because I did. I'm here now, got 50 million, you know. But, yeah, so continue to pray, and
Hi, my name is Jared, and I'm here to tell you that if you put your mind in anything, you'll be able to do it. When I was in high school, I undermined myself, and I didn't think I was able to do it, but once you put your mind to do it, you can do anything. I have my new invention. I have a car that can fly, so... Something like that. Yeah. Yeah. So if you put your mind to something,
you can accomplish it. All right, give him a round. All right, so what's the difference? What was the difference there? Anybody tell me? So what's the difference between telling you what I'm going to do and telling you where I already am? Yes? Confidence, right? So he had a really good imagination about being on, being a flying car, a movie with Tyler Perry. Again, you're engaging your imagination, you got a step of confidence, you've already figured you've done something. When the game's already over, you're not worried about losing. If you look at your sheet and you're worried about not doing it, you can't do that. You've got to imagine like it's already done. It's just a matter of you walking through the steps. So that's the type of confidence, that's the kind of vision that I need you guys to have. You're going to be successful. You're going to make it. That's what I need from you. That's what I need for you guys to do. So, Mr. Colin Pinckney, good friend of mine, author, He's a father, chaplain. He's got a lot of things under his back. I'll let him go into the details. I won't steal his thunder. One of my favorite guys. When I have a question about how to get something done, when I need advice, this is one of the men that I go to. This is one of my mentors. So I'm excited to have Mr. Colin Pinkney. We're going to give him a nice round of applause. We're going to do this. We're going to show him what we've been working on. You guys make me proud. Everybody ready? We're going to go with it. I'm going to give you an easy one this time because you missed 4-4-4 up here. So let's, can you guys do 4-4-4?
Yeah.
All right, let's go with that. All right. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
Sit up. Everybody ready? All right. I'm so proud of my boys. All right, 4-4-4. Let's go. On three. 1, 2, 3. Tom Pinkney.
Gentlemen, so first of all, let me say thank you to one of my mentors, one of my heroes. Great man who I'm just honored that I remember. I don't know how many years it's been, John. But John sat at my desk and told me about an idea he had where he would get young white men together, venues like this, and nobody else was doing it. And all I knew to do was say, we got to do this. And I look at this today, and I can tell you I'm honored and proud, not only that you men are in this room, but that John has set an example for you, that if you say you're going to do something, you're going to be a man about it. No matter how hard it gets, no matter what challenges come, no matter what resources you do not have, you keep your word. So I want to give one of those back to Mr. John. Have y'all done that for John yet? Let's give Mr. John Bart one of them four things y'all just gave me. How'd y'all do that? 4-4-4-3 for Mr. John Bart. 1, 2, 3. Look, guys, I'll try not to be here long. I get started talking, and I can talk all day. I do apologize for being late, and for the young man who called out black people who are always late. I got an excuse. I was at a black church this morning at another college, and they started late. And I got here late, but that's all right, because today is a great day. I'm honored to be here with you today. I want to introduce you to a couple of really special guys who follow me around in the back room back there. Young man will be sitting among you guys here just a few months. My youngest son, John Pinkney, 15 years old, West Mac High School. Let's give it up to John. And sitting in front of him, another young man who's like a son to me, but he's not my biological son, but he was a part of a book club I started at Olympic High School. Anybody here from Olympic?
There you go.
Yeah, Olympic in the house.
Big old.
We started a book club at Olympic High School 8 years ago, and Sean was one of the first students to go through it. He stayed there for a couple of years, went on to graduate, played football at Gardner Webb, and he's finishing up his senior year at Winston-Salem State University. This year, let's hear it from Sean Hunter. Right there. Some of the best linebackers this city has ever seen. I used to watch that boy play football and hurt me. Man. He ain't even a mean guy, he's a nice guy. Guys, I want to talk to you for a little bit about really piggyback off of what John, I just heard John sharing with you. And I want to walk you through an exercise I do with some of the men and young men in the book club I do. It's about understanding what leadership is and how do you draw on your own leadership to fulfill your life purpose and destiny, as John was just talking about. And Sean, would you come give me a hand real quick? I got it. In a minute, guys, I'm going to show you a movie clip. And here's what I want you to do. Sean, if you start handing out those cards. And if we've got enough, you can use these. If you don't have enough cards, you can use one of the cards on the table. But I'm going to ask you to do a couple of things. As you watch this video clip, I want you to write down what you think is the most important piece of the clip. I want you to watch silently. I want you to pay attention. And I want you to write down, when you see in this clip, what is the most important piece of leadership in this clip. Okay? And as Sean was passing that out, I'll tell you a little bit more about myself. I work in the community. I run a nonprofit agency called the Harvest Center of Charlotte. We help homeless men and women get off the streets and get back into productive lifestyle. Before doing that, I worked for 15 years with an organization called the Urban Restoration of Charlotte. Our whole purpose was to help inner city at-risk youth with programs when they were out of school to keep them focused and out of trouble, and so that they would at least not go to jail, go to high school, and hopefully go on to college.